Hello guys, welcome to this course on Terraform Basics. My name is Sijesh and this video we will see how to use count in a different way. So instead of hard coding or using the index based name for VM, so we use an array to define the VM name. So this is the file that we used for our previous deployment, and here we use a count hard coded, and so the VM name based on the count index. So here, first thing we are going to do is just open the variable file and create a new variable to accommodate the list of VM name. So we use the name as VM underscore name, and it's of type string of list. And we give some default values like blue, green, and red. And complete that and save this file. So we defined a variable VM underscore names for this VM name. Then go back to the main.tf, so where we are defining our resources. And here in, for the count, we use the length of that list. Okay, so we use length function to get that list and the variable, and variable name is VM underscore names. So instead of hard coding the count value, we use the length function that will return the length of elements in that array. Okay, so see that length var.vm name. So in this case, so we will get that count value as 3, but if we add some elements that will change. And also we change this tag name. So we need to get, or we need to take the elements from that array for each iteration. So for example, we use var dot vm underscore name. So that is the array or list that we define. So use vm underscore names, and we use count index. So the count index will be starting from 0 and to the one number less than the count. So we will get that array elements for each VM. So once this is done, go ahead and save this file and use Terraform init. So Terraform init will download the plugins based on the plugin provider that we define in the Terraform configuration file. So that is done, and now we need to make sure the syntax is correct by using Terraform validate. So we got a success message, so that means our code is perfect. So now we will see how this deployment works using Terraform plan. So Terraform plan lists the deployment detail. So here you can see, so it's going to deploy 3 resources. So that means based on our blue, green, red value, it will do the deployment. Finally, do the deployment using Terraform upline. And it takes some time to do the deployment, and once it's prompted, go ahead and type yes and then press enter key. So now actual deployment has started. So open AWS console and see, here you can see 3 VM are getting deployed with the name blue, green, and red. So again, it takes some time to do the actual deployment. Here you can see the VM detail. So based on instance example VM 0, 1 and 2. So that is done. And now just refresh here, and you can see this 3 VM are up and running. And if you go to the details and go to the tag section, so you can see the tag values for this name. So it's blue, green, red. So that's it, a deployment as a completed. Now we will just revisit the code. Okay, so here we used a variable VM underscore names, which is of type list of string, and default value given blue, green, and red. And back to our main file, so we used count value as length of this particular array. So if you update that array in the backend or during the deployment, if you pass some values to that array, so the count value will change. Okay, and for the name, so we are getting the elements from that array using count.index. So count.index will start from the 0, 1, 2, 3, so that you can take the elements from that array. So 0 means the first element, 1 means second element, and 2 means third element, like that. So that's it about this deployment. I hope you enjoyed this learning. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.